Hey guys, Bill Spadea here. Welcome to the Speaking Podcast here with my friends and co-hosts, Jessica Gibson and Jay Black. What's going on, guys?
Hello, Bill.
Hi, Bill.
By the way,
two weeks without me.
We have video now. I just need to tell you before we welcome you back, I did 3, 2, 1, and I pointed at you, but I hit record like on 2. So I just want to apologize.
Basically, the beginning of Speaking Podcast was cut off.
No. We went too early. So just apologizing to people at home, just like I apologized to my wife. Sorry, well, I went off a little early.
Wow.
I'm excited. What are you going to do?
Sorry.
You're excited. We're back from vacation. Now, have you guys taken any time off? I mean, Jay, you've been off pretty much since March, right?
I'm waiting to have time on again.
Jessica, you're still working from home, right?
No, I'm dying for a vacation day. I've been just like grinding since January, so I'm
Wait, Jessica, you're in a new office.
At my parents' house. I'm in Jersey. My spy dad is here, but he cannot come on the podcast because he's on official spy business.
Ooh, got it. Well, pass along our hellos. So it was nice to take 2 weeks off. It actually felt longer, which I know doesn't often happen, but it was nice to disconnect. I turned off my phone for a whole week, like off.
What did you do? What did you do if you don't have your phone? Like, I lived, not even joking, legitimately curious what people do if they don't have a phone with them constantly on.
You do everything else. You can hike, swim, talk. The conversations were more intense because there was no, wait, hold on. Like, if you think about it, how often, and Jay, you see this with your kids, right? How often, Keen is right in here.
Yeah.
Well, and this is kind of what it feels like every time. Yeah. So I turned it off. Now, the only challenge with not having a phone is I have no sense of direction.
Hmm.
So it was hard to get around. But I got back into yoga. My hair started growing again.
That is gross. Look at that.
It's been said that I look like a Bernie voter now.
Yeah. I feel like you should be on Chapo House. What is it? Chapo Trapo?
You look like a psycho yoga instructor.
I feel a little bit like that. You know, it was more gray than I thought. And then I mentioned, did you post a video, Jay? Was our last podcast a video?
The last podcast we all did together, yeah, was a video that we posted.
So somebody pointed out to me that, Jay's beard is not gray at all.
Yeah.
And we talked about that.
Yeah, so am I like 25 years older than you? Is that what happened?
No, I use chemical dyes in my beard. We've talked about this several times.
I knew that, but I didn't want to out you. I just ignored the comment.
I did a whole video for the old website about me getting it dyed. I have no shame in this.
I vaguely remember that. That was a long time ago. Was that like pre-coronavirus? Was that when the world was normal?
It was, I believe, 178 years ago.
Right, so... Listen, there's a weird thing I got to talk about. There was a news report earlier this week, and these podcasts are current, right? So this is dropping on Wednesday.
Yeah.
Okay. So this week, I get back from 2 weeks, not digesting any news. I'm not on Twitter, not on LinkedIn. And there's this weird phenomenon going on where people are getting mailed seeds from China. And the health department and other officials are saying, don't plant the seeds you're getting from China. I don't know. They're concerned about, something with the different, whether the bug's involved or these are plants that aren't natural to here. I don't know.
Invasive species. Yeah, it makes sense.
Okay. Well, does it make sense? Because I'm not so sure with the world the way it is today. But first of all, how do you receive unsolicited seeds from China?
Dark web, Bill.
I received unsolicited toilet paper. Now, here's the weird thing about... Hold on. I'm going to get it because it was very strange.
Unsolicited toilet paper. In today's economy, that's worth a lot of money.
Telling you about.
What was that?
The booze fairy in Bordentown where everyone's just leaving a basket of goodies of little liquor bottles on each other's... front door.
Oh, Jessica, you were talking about that the other day.
You got graced by the toilet paper fairy.
So, all right. So I get this. It's from La Puente, California.
Okay.
Valley Boulevard, Building B. And it looks to be, I don't know, it's an ethnic last name. I'm not going to read it here. Okay. So I get two packs of toilet paper, but they're
toilet paper too.
Well, they're it's like a travel size.
Yeah.
But they're 10 packs. One of them was used. This bag was open, and there was only 9 in it.
Right.
Now, I'm not sure what to do. I don't think I should give this to anyone or use the toilet paper. I'm thinking of throwing it away, but then I'm like, I don't know. Who? How does that, like, I don't want to reach out to the guy.
Bill, you're doing, you got to hold on.
I need some help.
Got to hold on to that toilet paper for when the second wave hits in September and everybody's out looking for toilet paper again. You got about $8,000 worth of toilet paper there, my friend. You hold on to that like a Picasso.
So do you think this is like currency size?
Yeah. Once we get, you just keep that in your pocket. You go out to the store and you're like, hey, gee, I need new wheels for my car. And they go, that'll be $800. And you go, or you wipe your butt for a week in –
now,
paper.
The brand says Element, and the slogan is the feeling of falling in love with you. This whole thing is very strange. I don't know. I don't know what to say about it.
Did it have your name on the packaging?
Yeah. So it was addressed. Hold on. It was addressed.
Hello, Kat.
Bill.
This is my sister's cat.
Was it at the radio station that it came in, Bill, or to your house?
No, it came to my house, which is, you know.
That's way scary.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, who's sending, I mean, we had an issue, as you know, with the severed deer head. That was a whole thing. I don't understand the toilet paper. I could understand if it was a new package. The fact that it was open has me somewhat concerned. It just, like, it was the guy in the bathroom at the post office and saying, well, uh-oh, they're out of paper. Let me grab this, and I'll just send them, you know, 19 rolls instead of 20.
This is like the old aunt in Christmas Vacation that has dementia and she's just wrapping up stuff she found in her house to give away as gifts.
It sounds like the guy who brought some bacon to you when you were talking
about it. I remember that. It was so crazy. Yeah, guy brought, you know that story, Jay. The guy brought bacon and got pissed off because I announced on the air that I wasn't going to eat the bacon that he clearly took off his plate and wrapped in a napkin. I mean,
and then he came back for it. What if they come back with toilet paper?
Well, I don't know. I don't know where I should look up where that is in California. But I don't understand. Like I don't recognize the name. I don't know.
We should seriously have a social skills class in middle school or high school where people are talked about like, hey, if you have the urge to like wrap up some random toiletry goods at your house and send it to a stranger, don't
do that.
Yeah.
Oh, we've lost all sense. So what are your thoughts? So Anne, our production director, Anne thought I should throw it away, but I'm concerned about just throwing it away. What if it's evidence?
Oh yeah. No, you got to take that under a black light for DNA.
Well, I was thinking, what if they send it to the wrong house and they're going to come back for it and say, I want it back. Like, it's very valuable toilet paper.
Right.
I mean, it's a good size. Like, it's a good travel size to put in your car.
Bill, are there clues written on the toilet paper to track down the Declaration of Independence?
Maybe. Maybe that's it. But one missing. I don't know. I don't know. And it's in, like, a weird bag. It was flown here. It went through LAX. It's just... like somebody paid to make sure I get this.
Yeah. We live in a very strange country. And I'll be honest with you. If I was in your position, Bill, I might hire like a kid in my neighborhood to open all my mail for me. Just in case there was
Like there's a liability issue there. I don't know that I would be willing to pay the kid enough to overcome said liability.
Yeah, he's a kid. That's why you get a kid. You have him sign a contract, ironclad, that if he blows up, not your problem. You got to think like a Republican, Bill.
Like the poison tester to eat all your food first?
Yeah.
That's what it is.
You make a
it's
lot
just
of
weird enemies. When it comes to your house.
Bill, you have the worst combination. You have a lot of enemies and you also want to be alive. I only have one of those things.
No enemies, right, Jay? No enemies.
Sure, yeah. Yeah, everybody loves me.
How's social media been?
It's well, that's I want Jessica, when it's over, I have somebody to reach out to, Jessica. I've been working real hard to increase my
Twitter. All right. Actually, I think we should have this conversation here for the good of our audience.
Yeah.
So, Jessica, there's a young woman on, is it Twitter, Jay, or is it Instagram?
She's, well, I mean, yeah, she's a young woman on Twitter. I got the idea that I was going to be a reply person. I'll go real quick and reply to, like big names, and I'll be the first one to reply. There I am. Look, oh, Jay Black.
3,000 followers.
Getting up to 3,000.
What's he up to?
2000. Almost there. Almost there.
But when I started back on social media, I was at 2,400. So I did 500 in the last, like, 6 weeks.
Wait, what are you at? You're at 2,500? You're 20,000?
No, 3,000, Bill. But I started at 2,400 when I came back.
So, Jessica, here, let me see if I absorb what Jay had explained to me earlier. He's like, my strategy is 100 followers a week by being the first and funniest person to reply to, a like, a blue check tweet.
Sure.
Some people, you just have to say first, and that's all they say to, like, a Justin Bieber tweet.
Right.
Just write first, nothing
but,
else.
But how do you do that? Are you literally constantly doing this?
No, so I dive in and out. And if you follow enough blue checks, there are guys that, like, tweet, like, we're, like, the Washington Post tweets, you know, 5 times an hour. So you just got to dip in whenever it's there. I see something, reply super quick, and I generally can write something funny. You get a bunch of likes and replies, and that's how I've been building my audience on Twitter.
All right, so Jay decides, he sees this young woman, caught his eye.
Well, because
she's not in a creepy way.
No, don't say caught your eye, Bill.
Sorry. Is that
you would not be asking for help with this if this wasn't creepy.
Well,
right. No, well, this is actually the whole point. Right. So 50,000 followers, Jay's like, I think we need to bring her on the podcast and have a conversation with how she did it. So I said, reach out to her. And we left it at that until now. I understand Jay does not want to reach out to her because he thinks that he's like creepy old guy reaching out to young woman on Twitter. There's no way for that not to look creepy. I say it's all professional. Like, I DM people all the time. I'm like, hey, I want you to come on the show or whatever it is. I don't know.
She's got I don't know. My whole feeling is
maybe who is she? I want to look her up now.
In general. Oh no, not Brianna Wu. It's Joe. Hang on.
You don't even remember her name?
No. If I did, that'd be even creepier.
I think, Jessica, what are the chances Jay is totally faking looking her up right now?
Oh, JoJo from Jers.
Wait, who?
JoJo from Jers. J-O-J-O, then from, then J-E-R-Z.
All right. So here's JoJo from Jers with what looks like the Beatles.
60,000.
Democrat, hothead. Come on.
Well, here's the thing. I told you, not from a political point of view, I see her doing the same kind of replies that I do super quick. And I was like, oh, there's somebody who's only been doing it 3 years, 60,000 followers. I think it would be interesting to find out how she did that. But then I was like, if I reach out, there's no tweet that I can write that doesn't sound like a sleazy producer saying, hey, you should come for a casting call. So I figured.
Jessica, what are your thoughts? I mean, I'm looking at this. Yeah, she's still left.
Like someone afraid to hit on a girl at a bar.
But no, I don't want to hit on her.
You need another friend to go swoop in and bring her in.
I don't want to hit on her.
Oh, sorry.
No, but that's the thing. That's what it looks like. So I was like, hey, we should get Jessica to do it. That way it can be all professional. I don't have to talk to anybody.
Well, it wouldn't have been weird if you just reached out in the first place. Now you've made it weird.
But that's what I do. That's the thing. Like, if you're walking at night, and there's a girl walking near you, and then you get the thought, oh, geez, I'm a guy. I'm walking near this girl. I hope she doesn't feel like I'm going to do anything bad. You can't say, just so you know, I'm not going to assault you. Like, that doesn't make anybody feel more comfortable.
at least you think about that type of thing. Like, some people will walk up and be like, oh, which block is the train station on? And all I'm thinking is, like, murderer.
Yeah.
Really? All right. So, Jessica, let's start there. Is there a certain look that you look for?
The one time I was scared out of my mind, they had, like, shaved heads, leather jacket, like, lots of facial piercings.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So they were just... Any kind of big dude, any big dude walking up to any girl who's by themselves, that's scary for them.
These are actually like probably smaller than me guys because I'm pretty tall, but they still like, I think, yeah, any dude when you're alone is like, you're like, what is that guy thinking? Why is he not considering before he approaches a girl alone on the sidewalk in a city at night?
Right.
Like,
that. And so how many times is it legitimate if you're the only one there? Like, I would think at a train station, if someone's asking you something, that could be very legitimate.
Yeah, but like half the time they are being very total creepy guys. So, yeah.
And see, that's the problem. Bill, a few creeps ruin it for everybody.
Yeah,
but you got to think like it's just the thinking thing of if I'm a dude and I'm out at night and I see like I have a girl by herself or literally anybody else I could talk to. Why talk to the one person I know is going to spend the entire conversation going, what's happening? Is this okay? Like, it's just, but you think about it, there's no way to make anybody feel better. So I just avoid it 100% and walk on the other side of the street.
That's why
I don't remember a time. What's that?
That's why quarantine is so good, because you don't even have to like pretend to like go and greet anyone anymore, especially when
see, this is there. Terrible, guys. This is why it's so bad. We are going to be unable to interact as human beings. I never thought of it. I think there are guys that just give off a creepy vibe, but I think there are also guys that simply don't.
Yeah, but the guys who don't have to at least, even if you don't at all.
I feel like if Jessica's dad, the spy, came up to just about any woman in any circumstance, you would not at any point think this guy's creepy. You'd be like, oh, that's somebody's dad. He's got a legitimate question. I'm here to help.
Maybe, but...
I agree, but my dad has not left the house since February.
Oh, so his social skills are gone.
He has. That's it.
Gone.
Let me ask you this serious question. You're out by yourself. You see a child, a boy, 6, 7 years old, crying, can't find his mother. Do you take the boy to the security office, or do you find a woman to take the boy to the security office for you so you don't look like a creep for taking the boy by yourself?
I only call 911.
Okay. And then run the, well, like if you're in the mall or something.
No, seriously, I every point before I approach, it's happened to me twice. I came up on an accident locally at an intersection and there were a couple people kind of milling around. I called before I got out of my car. And then I stopped for, there was an accident, God, it was years ago, on the Merritt Parkway. Same thing, I called as I approached before I even got out. Because you just don't know who you're going to see or interact with.
But that's the thing, I think that in a smaller way, I always try to find the thing that makes everybody involved as comfortable as possible. Because I don't trust myself to not say or do something that make people go, oh God, this guy's weird. And then you go, but I'm not weird. And then that makes you double weird by saying it.
Anyone that says I'm not weird has definitely got some issues.
Right. So I try to have other people do it so that I don't make anyone feel uncomfortable.
I'm uncomfortable right now. Jessica, yeah, what
exactly.
About
you? Exactly. And we're separated by 660 miles.
I can't wait to tweet at this JoJo girl and make her uncomfortable.
But you're not, though. She's going to be like, oh, look, a nice young lady wants me to be on a podcast versus creepy McBeardo who's trying to get my DMs. I don't want to be that.
Listen, I'm one of the very few Trump supporters with a ponytail, so I think that accounts for something. I think I've achieved some kind of a Zen balance.
You know what? That would be an interesting statistic. I'd like to get Nate Silver on this. Since quarantine, how many Trump supporters have ponytails now? Bet you it's double-digit percentage-wise.
It could be. It could be.
I think I love it.
This is a way easier way to keep your hair, by the way. There's no comb involved. There's no brush. There's no product.
I put product in for today. Look at this.
I can't get, wait, what is it?
I put product in, look. Very.
Yeah, good. That's what I mean. I mean, there's no reason for any product. It's just hair. Yeah. It's way easier. I think women have it easier.
That's the whitest, oldest guy thing you've ever said in the history of this show. I don't know why these ladies are complaining.
What are they complaining about? I literally
it's great this way.
There's literally no work. Here you go. Done. Here's done. There we go. And done.
Having brushed my daughter's hair several times, oh no. It's just the brushing is a process.
You know how to braid hair?
Yes. I can braid hair. I can paint toenails. I'm an all-purpose dad.
I think this girl has a million Instagram followers.
What's that?
I think this girl has a million Instagram followers.
A million?
Yeah. You're not on Instagram, though, are you?
No, I can only do one social media platform at a time.
Wait, are you only on Twitter? Really?
Only on Twitter, yeah.
That's what you picked out of all the options of social media?
1,000%. It's the only one that appeals to me because it's all about being witty and everything else I don't have time for. I don't have time to have.
All right. I like that. I appreciate that.
Yeah. I don't have time to have a life interesting enough for Instagram. And I also don't want to be the guy who goes, hey, to my daughter, I can't talk to you right now. I need you to line up for this shot for my Instagram stuff. So I just want to be witty, and that's all I care about. So that's why.
It's like in and out, quick hit. It's like a hit and run. I got it.
I can do a sentence pretty easily.
Jessica, I take you for a dog person.
This is my sister's cat, and I think because I started talking in the in the office, she came in to investigate. So she's.
What is the cat's name?
Carrie, like Carrie Bradshaw.
Oh.
I'm sure you guys have so much, like. Experience watching Sex in the City, right?
Does that cat have
a that feels like 100 years ago that was a thing.
Well, I feel like they replay it all on Netflix has Friends streaming and like it became like a big thing recently. Don't you see teenagers with Friends t-shirts on?
Yeah. Yeah, yes. My daughter loves Friends.
Really?
My 9-year-old favorite. Her favorite show is The Middle. Her second favorite show is Friends.
The Middle's pretty good. Yeah. I've seen it once, I think.
Hey, quick question.
I'm not a big TV watcher.
Is Sex in the City problematic now? I feel like it must be.
Yeah, I feel like that's something you couldn't really air like now.
Yeah, because Mr. Big, he's married in the show, right?
No.
I thought he got married to somebody else and Carrie was the...
Hey, I'm going to be honest. You know an awful lot.
Yeah.
About Sex in the City.
Why do you know so much?
Listen, when you're a sensitive man who wants to know what his woman's thinking, Bill, you watch the show.
Where all your Hallmark movies come from?
Yeah, I got a sensitive side. Look at this. This
guy's there is a good one on Netflix now called Dark. Have you seen it?
Not, no.
No.
Very good. It's good. It reminds me of that. What was that crazy thing you had us watch, Jessica? The alien guy.
Hansa.
Yeah, I watched that. That's wacky stuff.
Is he lying or did he actually work at that place?
No, I think it's wacky stuff, but it got me. So it connected to, I don't know if it was like, if you like this, you like this. Anyway, Dark is a Netflix series. It's a Netflix original. It's got 3 seasons. I've only seen a couple episodes, but it's very good. It's a twisted tale that you might even like, Jay.
Is it... is it like the Twilight Zone where each episode's standalone or is it like a group of...
No, it's a continuing theme. It starts with a suicide.
I'm already on board.
And it unravels as you go and you find out more and it's wild. It's wild. Yeah. It's very creative. It was well done.
I'll check that out.
I hate cats so much.
Jessica, I have...
I'm surprised this cat is so interactive. I thought cats...
Very annoying.
I'm a 2-cat person now against my will.
What? You have 2 cats?
Yeah.
Cats? What? Why?
I bought my Aunt Barbara. I had a cat that my kids wanted. And then I bought my aunt. My aunt is like pushing 80 and she lives by herself in quarantine and she had a stroke. So she can't leave. So she's getting really depressed. And we just go over and talk to her through the window essentially to cheer her up. But she can't go to church anymore. Big
church that's building. Worse than prison.
Oh, and so we were like, okay, let's get her a cat. And then she'll have at least something to take care of and she won't be depressed. So we got her cat. 4 days in, she's like, cat's annoying me. I can't have it. I don't want the cat anymore. So we were like, all right, but we don't want to take the cat. Can't take the cat back to the shelter. So now we have 2 cats. I'm a 2-cat. I'm a cat lady.
Wow. Don't get 3, Jay. It's going to be a problem.
I didn't want 1, Bill. I didn't want you know what? This is God punishing me for trying to be nice to my Aunt Bebe.
Aw, Aunt Bebe.
She was Aunt Barbara, but I couldn't pronounce it as a kid. So now she's Aunt Bebe.
So she became Bebe? I like that. Aunt What's the cat's name?
Sunday. Like Sunday, like that you eat. S-U-N-D-A.
What's the first cat's name?
Evie.
Evie? Evie really?
Sunday. Yeah, that's my life. And they are very, Jessica, they're very insistent. Evie loves me despite my obvious dislike of her. And she just comes and wants pets constantly. And I'm like, leave me alone. I'm working.
Apparently that cat gets fed 4 times a day. And I said this to my cat loving friends. And they said that they also feed their cats 4 times a day.
You leave the food out and the cat kind of figures it out on their own, no?
Well, I think that's kind of it. Like you can time some like machine to like release food.
Like Doc Brown in Back to the Future.
No, I don't get that reference.
Remember at the beginning, he had a machine that would dump the food out for Einstein, and it was malfunctioning, so it was just like doing the same can every day. So it had like a giant pile of food at the beginning of the movie.
No, I don't remember that. But now I feel like I should watch it again.
Yeah, just watch the first 2 minutes, and you'll go, Jay's brilliant. Look at that.
Jay was dropping all of these references the last 2 weeks that just went straight over my head.
So what have we decided that Trump hater girl is going to come on?
Yeah, did you reach out, Jessica?
Yeah, I wonder if she has 1 million followers and is actually a celebrity in some way.
I'm not sure. She's from...
Everyone knows a celebrity who's got... Right, Jay, you're a celebrity. You know.
I'm a local comic, Jay Black.
You are a local celebrity, Jay. Local celebrity.
My son's friends came over for a social distance birthday party. And they were out back watching. We got a projector, so they were watching movies on the out back, and they were doing the thing that boys do where they were like texting a girl like together, where they're all like working on the texts and going back and forth, and they found out she's a big comedy fan. So all of a sudden it was like, oh, I'm over at my friend's house, his dad's a famous comedian. And I was like, boys, I think we got to roll back on this.
I love it. Oh, who?
And then you're going to explain it, Jay Black, and she's going to go, I've never heard of him. That's the opposite of famous. You can't be famous if no one knows who you are.
All a good time, Jay.
Yeah, well, we'll get there.
Hey, how's the album doing?
I you know what? I don't know. I should probably call and check. I think we're doing pretty okay, like on Spotify streams and stuff. Yeah. But you got to get 800 million of them to make a nickel. So if everybody could go and just play it on Spotify, I'd appreciate it.
All right. I love it. We're in. All right, guys. I think I do have enough to label this now, from toilet paper to how easy women have it with their hair.
Yeah.
I think we're good to go. And internet creepers.
I'm not a creeper.
Creeper perception. That's all.
Right. All right.
Any accusations. All right, guys. Till Tuesday.
Wait, follow me at Twitter. Jay Black is funny. Get me to 3,000 by the end of the week. Come on, guys. Don't
get Jay to 3,000. At Jay Black is funny. And he is.
All right. Thanks, gang.
All right. See you guys.
Bye.